I'm interested in the adolescent brain and how the adolescents make certain decisions. We all remember our teenage years, and probably you even remember that you took some risks during this period of time. And I'm interested in why we take these risks when we are adolescents. So we know from this period that it's a period in which we try to explore, we want to find new possibilities, and we actually try to find our passion in life. But this also comes with certain risks, because during exploring, for instance, we can also explore the more negative things, so drugs or drunk driving, so we take more risks. And I'm interested in why these risks occur and what is behind this process. So I'm currently looking at the development of the brain, and we know that the brain is still developing during our teenage years, and we think that due to this development, we are more prone to make these risks. One thing that we discovered within the brain is that there are certain areas that are important when we make decisions. And one of these areas is very involved in emotional processes. So whenever we see something, we have an emotional reaction to it. But on the other hand, we also have these control areas, who are very important for planning our behavior or stopping behavior when we know that something is not good for us. And during adolescence, we see that these areas are not in balance. So the emotional areas are already fully developed, but these control areas still need to develop. And due to this imbalance, when adolescents come in a social situation where they are with their friends and in the heat of the moment, the emotion has more weight to it than the control areas. So when you talk to an adolescent in person, they know that what they do is risky, but in the heat of the moment with their friends and their peers around them, the emotions take the overhand and the control areas are not so much in place at the moment. So that's one of the exciting things that we have found in this area of our research. It's not all a negative thing. I mean, we all have to explore, we have to try new things, we have to know where our passions lie. So it's all part of the game, but I think that we may be able to guide adolescents maybe more if we understand what they're going through and why this is happening. Well, during my studies, I came into contact with research, and from the get-go, I was a very curious and very curious how things work. And I was in the opportunity to work at the lab I'm working at now, where we look at the brains and how these develop. And I was becoming so passionate about figuring out what happens and why do adolescents go through this actually magnificent phase and all these things that play a role. And yeah, I just wanted to learn more about it and to understand. That's one of the main reasons that I like research so much. It's so much facets that you can look at, and it creates even more questions than we can actually answer. So I think that's a very great thing about research.